This thing behind me is a green screen. You already know that. It's pretty obvious. It's green and it's a screen. What more can be said? I mean, you already know what a green screen does. I can just click my fingers. That's it. Background's gone. I'm in space for some reason. Not everyone has one of these. You know, this thing only cost me £4. It's really cheap and it's made of card, so it's quite crap in comparison to the more professional level ones. But regardless of price, not everyone has one. And I have a solution for those that just want to remove the background without a green screen. So here we are in a slightly different part of the flat. Now normally you'd look at this kind of background and say, I can't remove this. There's too much crap going on. It's not green, it's not blue, it's not different enough. And what do I do? Well, there you go. Background's removed. But you still kind of sat there wondering how I did that, right? Well, I'm going to show you, okay? Come with me. Step 1, stand in front of the background, get ready to go, and get out of the shot. Now for step 2. In Adobe Premiere, assuming you already have all your footage on the timeline, use the snapshot button to export the empty shot. If you don't have this button, you can either drag it in from the button editor or hit Ctrl+Shift+E. Step 3, layering. Now pay attention, the snapshot you just took goes on the bottom. Next layer up is your background, and on top of that is your subject. Think of it like a burger. Plain part of the bun on the bottom, meaty chunks in the middle, and the bun with the sesame seeds goes on top. Simple, right? Step 4, in the effects panel, look for the difference mat and drag it onto the clip that has your main subject. Then go to the effect controls and change the difference layer to the layer that has the plain background on, in this case being video 1. Step 5, just tweak the matching tolerance until it works. My footage sat around 5-7%, but yours will most likely be different. Now there's a few things to remember for difference mats, and the most important thing to note is the actual difference between the subject and the snapshot needs to be as exact as possible. You've probably heard about the rule of shadows on green screens. Well, for this effect it applies so much more. If the lighting changes, that's your effect ruined. So the effect isn't perfect, but for what it does, it can be a good alternative. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.